Hello fellow tankers, bonjour amis tankistes. In this video I will present you a quite nice top BR gameplay on the Tunisia map which will essentially exploit quite a few tips that I gave you in my main tutorial. This map is quite complex and very often quite frustrating, and the reason for that is that it's a map that you simply always win in A and B. In Arcade, in RB, you have to focus on A and B, and the reason for that is that it's so easy to communicate between the two camps, especially exploiting the river, but also this area. And that it's essentially very easy to attack and defend the two caps together, and the team which will control this area generally will control A and B and will win the game. That's as simple as that. Unfortunately, on this map, in Arcade, in RB, very often you will have a large fraction, if not most of your team, going to the completely irrelevant cap C. So it's a map which is simply always won in NB. So if you go to C, it's maybe to have kills, but you will, if you have too many of your allies on C, you will simply lose this game. It's a theorem, it's a mathematic theorem. You know, I'm a math scientist. And I can tell you that there is an equation proving that if a large fraction of your team is going to C, you lose the game. Okay. And the reason for that, again, is that from C, unfortunately, your only option is either to push to the enemy spawn, which is irrelevant, because this spawn is irrelevant, because that's the spawn to go to C. And the other alternative is actually to try to go to B through these positions. But unfortunately, if the enemy is holding the hill over there, and especially this passage here, you will be sniped as soon as you will try to emerge from there. So really concentrate on A and B, and don't waste your time by camping over there or camping over there, which is completely a waste of time. If you want to camp, let me remind you the few good camping spots that I have mentioned in my main tutorial. Here for the right side, here there is one position which is quite nice, which is good view on B, and essentially from the B side, I mean you can be around here, but there is essentially no good camping spot. I would say that this side, this camping spot here, is a bit better than that one. That one is simply horrible. The red side should simply never camp. This is absolutely horrible camping spot. The camping spot here is much better, but it's so easy to avoid the campers here, essentially by exploiting the river where they cannot see you, that they are almost as useless as the campers which would be there. So let's go to this gameplay, where, as you will see, I will really, I will ultimately cap A, B, and C, and our squad of two will carry this battle. So I am playing my French lineup in top BR, starting with this Leclerc S2, with its absolutely beautiful Austerlitz camo. Let me show you a bit. So it's a camo that you can find on the market, which is for a few gajin, which is not very cheap. I think it's around 8 gajin, but it's beautiful, and more importantly, it has the actual green used by the Fricolor French camo, whereas the Kark camo that we have in game is completely wrong. So these are actually the right colors of this tank. So I'm always starting with B in top BR from this side. From the other side, in A, sorry. From the other side, I may start to with B and then go to the water to go toward A. But very often, also, I start with A, and I simply never go to sea in the beginning of the battle. So in Topia, you have I really know, I have to tell you, I've been playing, having played thousands, if not 10,000 battles in tier 6, tier 7. I start to know all the best players at this BR, and they are all extremely aggressive players. Obviously not as being aggressive doesn't mean being completely reckless like the two tanks that we killed with Sudden Strike. Sudden Strike one for me one of the very best, if not the best player at this VR. And now we are pushing the people sniping on this hill, which are very often very bad players, because I mean after a few games you should understand that sniping from this hill is completely useless, has absolutely no impact, you see nothing. As soon as you emerge you die, and one of the reasons is that this hill is a bit steep, and to emerge and to snipe you have to show a large fraction of your tank, and you will be sniped from the blue hill, which is much better. So simply never snipe whatever the VR from this hill, which is completely useless. So this gameplay will be a bit dirty in the sense that we will be extremely aggressive against what you can call paid actors. But as you can see, I missed my my shot against the paid actor, and I was wrecked by the IT-1 that I killed. I killed. He took a backup, and unfortunately, I will die soon. And I will be wrecked by artillery. Let me accelerate, and I'm essentially abandoning my tank and taking a bomber. And interestingly enough, I see that this guy killed me, this camper in the position that I actually mentioned before in the first part of my replay. And this camper kills me, but as you will see, has been killed by my bombs. So I am respawning with my Leclerc S1, which also featured a nice camo, which is a project. I don't know if it will be really used, but which is a camo, a real camo used currently by the French army. And I'm going to be, and especially in IBR, I advise you to come to be from this approach. And obviously when you come from there, you have to be careful of tanks in this area. But obviously after what we did in the beginning of the game, there is nothing left there. Let me mention that instead of camping in this area, which is completely useless, if you really want to camp on this map for the red side, camp in this area. But it's only one or two tanks job. You should not need to have that many tanks. So here I have to be a bit careful, because there are a few campers. You don't see them on the map, but on my left. And I'm going to sea. So you see, you can actually go to sea from B quite effectively, which actually can be more effective than the frontal approach, especially when the enemy is holding C. And I'm flanking this M1, which was blocking our entire team. And I'm uncapping C. So let me accelerate a bit while I'm uncapping. And since the game is essentially won, I'm pushing toward the enemy spawn. Again, there is no shame in finishing the enemy in their spawn, but only when you control the different caps. So here there was a lot of lags in the game. It was on the American server. In the game, I remember that this M1 was flying a bit, and I killed it. So the problem of going to sea, especially in the beginning of the game, is that again you will be either stuck in sea, but if you control sea, you will not be able really to go toward B. And very often the only option, which is a bit stupid, is to go early in the spawn, the enemy spawn. And my advice, if you lose your east spawn, don't respawn there. There is no problem in abandoning sea. But obviously, if you respawn from the other side, there is an option also to go flank, for instance, from the right side, to go flank the spawn killer by coming actually from this part of the map. But again, if your team is concentrating on A and B, there is no way you will lose this game. Whereas, again, if most of your team is going on C and dying there, there is no way you will win the game. So, I told you this gameplay will be a bit dirty, but I mean, at one point, this is war, and it's a game, obviously. Obviously, this gameplay was also a nice opportunity to show you that aggressive stance in top BR actually works. And as you can see, our squad of two had actually more kills than the rest of our team. And more or less the guys that you see at zero, with zero kill, zero assist, or maybe one pitiful assist, are the people who were sniping over the hill on A, whereas we were wrecking the enemies which were on the other hill above A. So I thank you for watching and also for supporting this channel by subscribing if you didn't do it yet, and by firing a few likes, even to this quite dirty video, but hopefully which will convince you that again an aggressive gameplay is actually what wins games in top BR. See you on the battlefield, à bientôt sur le champ de bataille.